we want to find an equation of a polynomial function with real coefficients having zeros positive 3, negative 1, and 4, plus 2i. Notice how we're given one complex zero of the polynomial function, but complex zeros always come in conjugate pairs, meaning in the form of a plus or minus bi. So if we know 4 plus 2i is a zero of the function, then 4 minus 2i must also be a zero of the function. So we know our polynomial function has 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros, therefore we're going to find a degree 4 polynomial function. Next, knowing the zeros of a polynomial function gives us information about the factors of the polynomial function. A polynomial function f of x must contain binomial factors in the form of x minus the given zeros. So if we have a zero of positive 3, the function must contain a factor of x minus 3. If we have a zero of negative 1, we must have a factor of x minus negative 1, which simplifies to x plus 1. If one of the zeros is 4 plus 2i, one factor must be x minus the complex number 4 plus 2i. And if we have a complex zero of 4 minus 2i, one of the factors must be x minus 4 minus 2i. Now let's take a look at these factors that contain the complex numbers. We could leave it in this form, but I think it's going to be easier to keep track of the signs if we clear these parentheses here and here by distributing this minus sign, or we can think of distributing a negative 1. So let's go ahead and do that now. We'd have f of x equals the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity, this will be x minus 4 minus 2i. And then here we're going to have x minus 4, and then negative 1 times negative 2i is positive 2i, so we'll have minus 4 plus 2i. Now we still need to find this product. To do this, we only multiply two at a time, so we're going to multiply these two, then we're going to multiply these two, and then find the product of these products. So we'll have f of x equals, so we'll have x times x, or x squared, then we'll have x times 1, that's 1x, and then negative 3 times x, that's negative 3x, 1 plus negative 3x is negative 2x, or minus 2x, then we have negative 3 times 1, it's negative 3 or minus 3. This is the product of these two binomial factors, and now we'll find the product of these two. Because there are three terms here and three terms here, we'll have nine products. So x times x is x squared, x times negative 4 minus 4x, x times positive 2i, that's plus 2xi, negative 4 times x minus 4x, negative 4 times negative 4, that's plus 16. Negative 4 times positive 2i, that's minus 8i. Now we have negative 2i times x, that's minus 2xi. Negative 2i times negative 4, that's plus 8i. And then finally we have negative 2i times positive 2i, that's minus 4i squared. Now we want to simplify this. Notice how here we have plus 2xi minus 2xi, that's 0. Here we have minus 8i plus 8i, that's 0. And now we need to combine the like terms. So we have f of x equals the quantity x squared minus 2x minus 3. The second factor is going to be x squared. Then we have negative 4x minus 4x, that's negative 8x or minus 8x. Then we have 16 minus 4i squared, but remember I squared is equal to negative 1, so this is negative 4 times negative 1, that's positive 4. 16 plus 4 is positive 20, so we have plus 20. And now we need to find this product. So again, we have three terms here and three terms here, we'll have nine products. So we'll have f of x equals, we'll start by distributing the x squared into the second trinomial. So we'll have x squared times x squared, that's x to the fourth. x squared times negative 8x. That's going to be negative 8x cubed, or minus 8x cubed. X squared times 20, that's plus 20x squared. Now we'll distribute the negative 2x. Negative 2x times x squared, that's going to be minus 2x cubed. Negative 2x times negative 8x, that's plus 16x squared. Negative 2x times positive 20, that's minus 40x. Now we need to finish by distributing the negative 3. Negative 3 times x squared, minus 3x squared. Negative 3x times negative 8x, that's plus 24x. And negative 3 times positive 20, that's minus 60. The last step here is to combine like terms and write everything in descending order. So we have x to the fourth, and then we have a negative 8x cubed, negative 2x cubed, so we have minus 10x cubed, and we have 20x squared plus 16x squared minus 3x squared, so that's going to be 36x squared minus 3x squared, that's going to be plus 33x squared. Then we have negative 40x plus 24x, that's going to be negative 16x, or minus 16x. Then we have minus 60. This polynomial function would have these zeros given above. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.